Hi, in this video we'll talk about Southern blotting. This technique was invented by Edwin Southern in 1975. Southern blotting can be used to detect a specific DNA sequence in a mixture of DNA. So let's say we have a mixture of DNA and our DNA of interest is present in that mixture. Southern blotting can allow us to detect whether it is present or not in this particular DNA mixture. These days, if we ask the same question, we would be using PCR technique. In PCR, we use specific primers to amplify our DNA sequence of interest. Now, in these days, the biggest question is, what is the relevance of Southern blot if PCR can do the same thing? Indeed, Southern blot is an obsolete technique these days. PCR is much more sensitive, accurate, and faster technique compared to Southern blot. But back in 1970s, Southern blot was the technique and it has revolutionized the molecular biology field. PCR was discovered in 1985 by Carey Mullis. 10 years back, Southern blot was already there. So let's look at how the Southern blot technique works. The starting material is genomic DNA, and then restriction digestion of that genomic DNA is performed. In this tube, restriction enzymes are added and the DNA would be now fragmented into smaller fragments. These fragments are then separated using an agarose gel. Then this particular gel is pretty flimsy and hard to work with. So all the DNA content from this gel would be transferred into a nitrocellulose membrane using electroblot technique. So electrical transfer would allow the DNA to be transferred from the gel to the nitrocellulose membrane. As DNA is negatively charged, so DNA would move from negative electrode to positive electrode, and in this process the DNA from the gel would be transferred or blotted onto the nitrocellulose membrane. Nitrocellulose membrane is a lot easier to handle in comparison with a gel. Now, all of the DNA content is transferred into the nitrocellulose membrane. In order to identify our sequence of interest, a specific probe would be used that would be complementary to the sequence of our interest. This probe is labeled with some kind of radiolabeled probes or other means of visualization, because we need to understand whether the probe has hybridized or not. For detection purpose, these probes were radiolabeled at that particular point of time in 1970s. Now the probe would hybridize to the particular complementary sequence as shown here. Then we need to remove excess probes or non-specific hybridization by washing these particular nitrocellulose membrane several times. After washing it out, the patterns would be more specific. From the nitrocellulose membrane, these patterns would be developed in an autoradiogram, and then the autoradiogram would be analyzed for several purpose or data analysis purpose. Let us look at what are the applications of this particular Southern blot technique. Now, Southern blot was discovered in 1975, and roughly after 9 years, Alec Jeffries has used these kind of approaches in forensic sciences. And in DNA fingerprinting, Southern blotting is used. So let us try to understand. Here is a crime scene from where some DNA sample is obtained, and we have two prime suspects. So the DNA from suspect 1 and 2 would be isolated and restriction digest. Similarly, the DNA from the crime scene would also be isolated and restriction digested. All of these DNA would be used to perform RFLP analysis. If you want to learn more about RFLP, you can click on the link in the I button and it would lead you to that particular video. But from that RFLP pattern, we can understand which of the suspect was present in the crime scene. If the patterns are exactly similar to the crime scene, then we can understand suspect 2 was present in the crime scene and involved in the crime. Just like in forensic sciences, Southern blot can be applied in many other aspects. At least theoretically, it was used in that point of time. Apart from forensic sciences, it was used for phylogenetic studies, identification of viral strains, paternity or maternity analysis, and diagnosis of genetic diseases. But nowadays, same application utilizes different techniques. In this era of high-throughput sequencing, things have changed. Now, we need to understand the limitation of this technique. It is extremely slow and cumbersome with a lot of steps. It involves radio-level probes, which is kind of hazardous. Then, genomic DNA from the crime scenes, which is obtained, might be very less. So, the starting material and the quantity of starting material could be an issue in terms of forensic sciences. Now, the biggest question that we need to ask at the end of this video is Southern blot at all relevant in the era of high throughput sequencing? Unfortunately, the answer is no. But back in 1970s, this particular technique has revolutionized molecular biology. PCR wouldn't have born, or DNA fingerprinting wouldn't have been there if Southern blot was not invented. So, this is the quick summary of the whole technique. So if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. You can find many such videos. Look at my playlist and it would be really beneficial for you. As usual, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram, Facebook. My ID is given here. Thank you for listening. Do let me know in the comment if you have any suggestions or your impression on this video. Thank you.